In this video, we'll show you how to read a file in KNIME. Different file types, such as Excel files, CSV files, and other text-based files, have dedicated reader nodes, but they all share a similar configuration interface. With these reader nodes, you can also access files in remote locations. Let's take a look at the Excel reader, for example. Its first configuration option is this input location here, which defines the path to the file to read. You can find this setting with exactly the same interface in other reader nodes as well, for example, the CSV reader and PMML reader. In the Read From section, we select the file system type and, if it's required, the specifier. In the first drop-down menu, we have four options for the path type: local file system, mount point, relative to, and custom KNIME URL. First, let's select local file system. This type accesses a file based on its location on the local machine. You can write the path manually, or click the Browse button. The file field then shows the path from the system root directory to the selected file. The whole path can vary depending on the operating system. Secondly, let's select the mount point option. This type accesses a file in the KNIME Explorer using a path that starts with the name of the mount point. We select the name of the mount point in the second drop-down menu: local, my KNIME hub, or a KNIME server mount point. If a mount point is not connected, it appears gray in the menu and can't be selected. Here, we select local and click Browse to select a file in the local workspace. After selecting a file, the file path only shows the path within the local workspace. Thirdly, let's select the relative to type, which accesses a file based on its location relative to the current mount point, current workflow, or current workflow data area. If we select the current mount point as our relative to path type, in this case local, we can browse files in this local workspace. The convenient thing about the relative to type is that for this path, the mount point is updated automatically. So if we deployed the workflow to a KNIME server or the KNIME hub, the node would execute without reconfiguring. If we select the current workflow, we can select any file under the currently active mount point so that the file path starts from the location of this workflow. Moving to an upper folder level is indicated by two dots in the path. If we select the current workflow data area, we can browse files in a data folder inside the workflow. This folder is not visible in the KNIME Explorer. However, if we open the local workspace in the File Explorer, we can see that each workflow appears there as a folder. Furthermore, the workflow folder can contain a subfolder called Data. We can also create the folder if it doesn't exist. If we read a file from this workflow data area, the reader node will always execute in any location: when exported as a KNWF file, when deployed to a KNIME server, when shared via the KNIME hub, and when moved within the local workspace, because the data folder always moves together with the workflow. The fourth path type is custom KNIME URL. This path only consists of one part: a URL address or a path starting with the KNIME protocol. Sometimes we want to read tables from multiple files and concatenate them into one table. We can do so with a single reader node, for example, the Excel reader or CSV reader. For that, we select Files in Folder in the Mode section and the path to the folder here below. The dialog behind the Filter Options button lets us include and exclude files by their file extension, file folder name, and visibility. If this Include Subfolders option is disabled, the files must reside on the topmost folder level. If it is enabled, files inside subfolders will be read as well. So far, we've only accessed files either in the KNIME Explorer or on our local machine. However, the same reader nodes can read files in remote locations as well, if we provide the connection in the input. For example, let's access some files on Amazon S3. We use the Amazon Authentication and Amazon S3 connector nodes to create the connection. The connection is then provided to the reader node via its dynamic file system connection input port, which is hidden by default, but can be added via the three dots in the bottom left corner of the node. Once connected, the configuration dialog only shows the connected file system in the Read From section. We can browse over the remote folders and files just as we did on the local file system. Once we have selected a file, the file path includes only the path within the remote location. Therefore, if we switch the input connection to another remote file system, for example, to Google Cloud, the node will still execute if the path to the file remains the same. In this video, we've shown how to read files in KNIME. Configuration of the file location is similar across most reader nodes, supporting the following file path types: a local path on the local machine, a path starting with the mount point name, a path relative to the current mount point, workflow, or workflow data area, a custom URL, and paths within remote file systems.